personality disorders are maladaptive and inflexible patterns of cognition, emotion, and behavior, and they generally develop in late childhood or adolescence and continue into adulthood. Now, there are three distinct clusters of personality disorders. There's odd and eccentric personality disorders, there's dramatic and emotional personality disorders, and anxious, fearful personality disorders. Now, we're going to examine the first two in more detail. Let's first start by looking at the odd and eccentric personality disorders. First, we have schizoid personality disorder. We see that people with this disorder do not want to be close in any of their relationships. They're reclusive, emotionally aloof, and humorless. And they also want to live solitary lives. Therefore, we see them engage in solitary activities. They have no interest in sex, they don't have close friends, and they don't seem to react to praise or criticism from others. Another odd eccentric diagnosis is schizotypal personality disorder. Here we see these individuals being isolated and asocial, but we also see that they have odd thoughts, perceptual distortions, and beliefs. And we may see that these people dress, act, or appear in peculiar or eccentric ways. And finally, let's look at paranoid personality disorder. People with paranoid personality disorder are extremely suspicious and mistrustful of other people in ways that are unwarranted and not adaptive. They may often test the loyalty of their friends and lovers because they believe others are trying to harm them. People with paranoid personality disorder may be regularly suspicious of their spouse's faithfulness, even if there's no evidence that the spouse has been unfaithful. But remember, these are extremes of personality. So questioning the faithfulness of a significant other doesn't necessarily mean you have a personality disorder. Remember, you would have to be extremely paranoid to the point of it interfering with your daily life to consider this a personality disorder.